Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we will discuss MOV, varistor, VDR, TVS. If we check this board, we have this red color V3, V2, V1. And if we see here in the same board, it is written VDR3. The same component VDR3. It have some raised surface here in both sides, and the same as VDR4 in red color. VDR4, if we check this power supply far higher, we have the same component. It is VR1 and it is in Z shape, the symbol Z shape. In this power supply, it is mentioned ZD1. It is at input filter circuit. In this power supply, we have this yellow shape. What is this component? It is basically a question from one of my viewers from Grace Electronics. So let's discuss. It is varistor, voltage dependent resistor, or we can say it is MOV, metal oxide varistor, VDR, voltage dependent resistor. Or it is named TVS, transient voltage surge suppressor. And if we see in the circuit diagram, we can see the symbols like this. Might be there is a symbol like this, a resistor, and Z shape, a resistor, Z shape cut, a resistor, Z shape. Might be mentioned U or V, or we have like this Z symbol. Then we have a double diode. That is dike. It is the same. It is a voltage dependent resistor, VDR. If we see a potentiometer, its resistance will change linearly. We can see it is resistance changes linearly. But this VDR, it is a variable resistor. Its response is ohmic, and it is non-ohmic resistance. We will discuss why it is non-ohmic resistance. One plate is here that is connected to this pin. Second plate in this side, which is connected to the second pin. We have two plates which are filled with ceramic grains with oxides. Copper oxide, germanium oxide, bismuth, cobalt, manganese, zinc oxide. Ceramic metal oxide. So different materials are filled inside. If you see construction is the same as I discussed here. This is the cut view. It is filled in with grains of ceramic or any other oxides. When it is filled in, it becomes like a capacitor. It have two plates and it is filled in with some oxide materials. When the voltage will reach above its specified limits, that will depend on the specification of the material. At that time, it will conduct. It will cause to flow the current from this material. Less than that, it will not allow to flow the current. When the voltage will reach above the limit, that time it will give a path to flow the current. Now we discussed varistor. Voltage dependent resistor, a resistor which have non-ohmic response, and it depends on the amount of voltage. When the voltage will reach above specified limits or below specified limits, it will give 0 ohm. Normally it is working as open circuit. When the voltage will reach above that limit, it will give the easiest path. TVS, transient voltage surge suppressor. What is transient suppressor? Let's see. Normally it is connected in parallel line and neutral. It is used for protection. In normal, when the voltage are less than its rated value, it will stay silent. When the voltage will reach above than its limit, here are voltage, forward voltage. If this component is for 250 volt, less than 250 volt, it will remain silent. But if the voltage will reach above than 250 volt, it will allow to flow maximum current either in positive side or either in negative side when the voltage will reach from forward or reverse. So it is double directional conductor. It is used as a protection if we installed in parallel to the transistor any switching device. So here it will protect this transistor. For example, its maximum allowed voltage are 250 volt. Above than 250 volt, if this coil will generate more voltage, then it will bypass, it will protect this transistor from over voltage. It can be used in three line configuration for common mode and differential mode. This varistor is used here in two line. If we use it in three line, then line to earth and neutral to earth, neutral to ground. Any noise in any line that will be eliminated here. Now we can see what is a spike. Non-conductive in parallel line when voltage is in limit. What is the limit? This is our line voltage. We can say it is 220 volt. If the voltage, a slight peak will come in the this frequency for a short period. This is period. In this time, if a spike will reach above than the limits, at that time it will clamp. 250 volts will remain in the line. The other voltage will, this spike will clipped off. So it will clamp or suppress the spike that is above them. What is the limit? If we see here, in this example, we have two spikes, spike A and spike B. This is our normal level. Any spike above than the normal level from upside or low side. If there is a spike here or spike here from center value, it is using, for example, 250 volt. From 250 volt, the upper voltage or lower voltage will be clamped by this component. If the voltage exceed from the maximum limit and energy handling of this component will exceed from its limit, when there are very high voltage and very high current, at that time its internal temperature will increase. For normal spikes, it will remove that are for short period. It will remove, its response time is nanoseconds, 40 to 60 nanoseconds. It will clip the spikes. If we have a permanent or very huge amount of voltage and current, at that time the thermal stress will increase and this material will heat up. The internal material will heat up. In that case, it will become short circuit. When it will become short circuit, it will give high amperage between these two leads. In that condition, in line, if we are using here fuse, normally it is not working. When it will become short circuit, it will allow the maximum current to this path. And when we have a parallel short circuit, there will no current flow in the next circuit because that will have high resistance. When we have parallel short circuit, maximum current will flow from this MOV. No current will go, or very limited current will go to the circuit. When it will cause to increase the current, the fuse will burn out. When the fuse will burn out, it will disconnect it and our circuit will be protected. Catastrophic failure. It is the condition of any component when it will damage permanently. It will destroy it. At that condition, it cannot be recovered. In that condition, we have to replace that component. So if we see its data sheet, in data sheet we will see the voltage. How much are the voltage? Then we, in the data sheet, we see energy. How much energy can handle this component? Operating voltage and response time. If you see a mobile device, there we can see 1 nanosecond response time. In normal circuits, 40 to 60 nanosecond response time. Then it have a maximum current. How much amount of current will cause to flow when the maximum voltage limit will achieved? how much amount of current, how many amperes will there. Then we can see breakdown or clamping voltage in the data sheet. There will mentioned how much voltage are the upper limit or lower limit, either it is DC or AC. Then capacitance, because basically it works like a capacitor. It have two plates and internally it is filled with some non-conductive material. It will conduct above than the voltage limit. Before that, it works like a capacitor. So it is a safety component, it is a protective component. It is used in parallel to any load, any component, any circuit to protect it. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, give a like. And if you have not subscribed my channel, subscribe it. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.